Welcome to the channel Easy Geography, an easy way to learn geography concept. Don't forget to subscribe the channel. This video include the topic continental drift, plate tectonic and other theories. These theories are related to the present arrangement of continents and ocean basins. After completing all the MCQs, you will get a basic idea about the theories. Then you will be able to attend all the questions related to this. First question, the term pole fleeing force related to. Pole fleeing force. Options, force responsible for bulging at the pole. Magnetic forces emitted through the poles aligning landforms on Earth. Outward directed forces associated with the spinning of Earth. Forces that cause oscillations in the tilted axis of Earth. Pole fleeing force means pole fleeing force related to the rotation of the Earth. Thus, the answer is option C. Outward directed forces associated with the spinning of Earth. The option A, forces responsible for bulging at the Earth's pole. It is a wrong statement. Forces, and this force is responsible for bulging at the equator. Pole fleeing concept evolved in 1950 by Alfred Wegener, and he used this name to explain the ideas of continental drift, and we will learn more about the continental drift later. And here the pole fleeing force, and he suggested that differential gravitational force and Earth's flattening would cause continental masses to drift slowly towards the equator, and due to the rotation of Earth there will be a flattening at the poles and bulging at the equator, and it causes the continental masses to move towards the equator. And pole fleeing force related to the rotation of Earth. Okay. Who propounded the theory tetrahedral? Options, Lothian Green, Harry Hess, Alfred Wegener, W.J. Morgan. Tetrahedral theory related to Lothian Green. The theory was postulated in the year 1875, and it attempting to explain the arrangement of continents and ocean basins, and it explained the continents and oceans are roughly in triangle, and it is also saying about the dominance of land masses in the northern hemisphere and water bodies in the southern hemisphere. Distribution of land masses are high in the northern hemisphere. This theory explains two terms, they are tetrahedral and sphere. Tetrahedral means the body which contains least volume with respect to surface area. Sphere means contains largest volume with respect to the surface area. And in the tetrahedral theory, the important things are, it is saying about the shape of continents and oceans. It is roughly triangle, and the dominance of land masses in the northern hemisphere and water bodies in the southern hemisphere. Then, who postulated the concept of horizontal displacement of continents? Horizontal displacement of continents. Options, F.B. Taylor, Gregory, Lothian Green, Wegener. Answer is option A, F.B. Taylor. And the continental drift theory, different terms are there. The hypothesis of continental drift, idea put forward by F.B. Taylor. Hypothesis of continental drift, the idea of continental collision. And then the drift hypothesis was propounded by Antonio Slider. Drift hypothesis. Then the continental drift theory put forward by Alfred Wegener. Hypothesis of continental drift, F.B. Taylor. Drift hypothesis, Antonio Slider. Continental drift theory by Alfred Wegener. Question. Which of the following is formed due to tectonic force? Formed due to tectonic force. Options, superimposed valley, super valley, rift valley, hanging valley, due to the tectonic force. And we know superimposed valley and super valleys are formed due to running water, then hanging valley is due to the glaciers, and thus the answer is rift valley. These are formed due to the tectonic plate movement in the Earth's crust, and are formed due to the moving away of plates and caused the deep cracks, and deep cracks are known as rift valley, otherwise it is known as graben, and the raised portion in the two sides of rift valley is known as block mountain. Next question. What name was given to the landmass of Carboniferous by Wegener? Options: Pandalasa, Panchia, Laurasia, and Gondwana land. This question related to the continental drift theory by Wegener. And according to the continental drift theory, during the Carboniferous period, there was only one continent and is surrounded by a large ocean. And the question is, the name of that supercontinent is? And it was Panchia. Named the supercontinent as Panchia and the surrounded ocean as Pandalasa. Then the Panchia split into Laurasia and it is in the north and Gondwana land in the south. Next, which of the following was not a part of Laurasia? Options: North America, Europe, Asia, Africa. And according to Wegener, the Pangaea split into two, Laurasia in the north and Gondwana land in the south. And among the following, which is not included in Laurasia? Answer is Africa, and all others are in the northern hemisphere and thus as a part of Laurasia. Africa is a part of Gondwana land. Here, the Pangaea split into two, Laurasia in the north, Gondwana land in the south. The North Pangaea, Laurasia include North America, Europe, Asia. And the Gondwana land or South Pangaea, it include India, Africa, South America, Australia and Antarctica. According to Wegener, which among the following forces could be said to be responsible for continental drift? Wegener explaining about some forces that are responsible for the drifting of continents. And the options: ridge push force, convection currents, magma force and tidal force. Which force is responsible for the movement of continents according to Wegener? Answer: tidal force. Responsible for drift are the equatorward movement is due to gravitational force and force of buoyancy, and the westward movement is due to the tidal force, and next force is centrifugal force. And Wegener explaining about three forces that are responsible for the movement of continents. First one, the equatorward movement. The equatorward movement is due to gravitational force and force of buoyancy, and the westward movement of continents is due to the tidal force, and then the centrifugal force. Next one, in which geological period equator was passing through the Third Sea? And all the theories, this continental drift, plate tectonic, all these theories are explaining about the movement of continents and oceans. With this movement, the location of equator is also moving. And the question is, in which geological period equator was passing through the Third Sea? Options: Tertiary period, Pleistocene period, Pliocene and Miocene. Answer: during the Tertiary period. During the Tertiary period, the location of equator is through the Third Sea. Here explaining about the position of equator at different period. And during the Silurian period, the position is at north of Norway. Carboniferous period, London. And Tertiary period, present location of European and Alpine mountain. And Quaternary period is the latest period and it is at the 0 degree. Gondwana land disrupting during the Cretaceous period. The present arrangement of continents and ocean basins were attained during the Pliocene period. And the explanation about this period, then others are included in the geological time scale. Question: which of the following evidences support the theory of continental drift? The statements are jigs of it of shorelines of Africa and South America, occurrence of gold deposits in Ghana coast but the absence of any source rock there, all the East, South American and West African coast are good natural harbors. Choose the correct answer using the quotes given. Option A, 1 and 2. Option B, 2nd and 3rd statements are correct. Option C, 1 and 3rd statement, 1st and 3rd statements are correct. All of these are correct. Supporting evidences of continental drift. Answer is option A. First and second statement is correct. The jigsawfit of shorelines of Africa and South America. Jigsawfit means the coast fit together like a pieces of jigsaw puzzle. The shorelines of Africa and South America fit together. And next one, the occurrence of gold deposits in Ghana coast, but the absence of any source rocks there. There is large deposits of gold in Ghana, but the supporting rocks are absent there. Then the nature of harbor is not an evidence for continental drift theory. Evidences of supporting continental drift theories include, first one, the jigsawfit. Jigsawfit means the coast of Africa and South America fit together like a pieces of jigsaw puzzle. And then the fossil evidences. Fossil evidence means the remains of identical fossils are found in opposite separated continents, and the same rock types are also found in the separated continents. And then the paleoclimatic evidences. Paleoclimatic evidence means glaciation. Then other climatic variations happens in the separated continents at the same time. Then paleomagnetic evidences. It is related to the polar wandering force. Which of the following are the base of plate tectonic theory? Base of plate tectonic theory. The statements are concept of continental drift, concept of seafloor spreading, geosynclines theory, theory of isostasy, which are related to the plate tectonic theory. Options A, first statement, first theory only, B, 1 and 2 only, option C, 3 and 4 only, D, all of these. And we know the plate tectonic theory related to continental drift theory and the concept of seafloor spreading. And the answer is option B. Continental drift theory and seafloor spreading. One, with reference to the plate tectonics, consider the following statements. Statements are, it is the theory that Earth's outer shell is divided into several plates that glide over the planet. Second one, it is another name of the theory of continental drift. Third one, it discards the conventional geological view that there is convectional current flowing in the mantle. With reference to plate tectonic, which of these statements are correct? Option A, first statement only. Option B, second statement only. Option C, third statement only. Option D, 1 and 3 is correct. Answer is option A, the first statement only correct. And the plate tectonic theory, it was postulated by W.J. Morgan, and it is saying about, it is the outer shell is divided into 6 major plates and 20 minor plates, and they are moving over the mantle. The plate tectonic theory is related to the continental drift theory, but it is not same. And thus the second statement is correct. And about the convectional current flowing in the mantle is not saying in the plate tectonic theory. It is not related with that. Thus, the first statement is the correct. Next, which of the following about the tectonic Indian plate is not correct? In the plate tectonic theory, W.J. Morgan saying about 6 major plates and 20 minor plates. India is on among the plate. And about the Indian plate, which of the statements is not correct? Options A, it is a major tectonic plate. Option B, it forms the convergent plate boundary with the Himalayas. Option C, the Indian plate is tectonically separated from the peninsular Indian plate. Option D, the plate extends to Pakistan and Myanmar as well. Incorrect statement about the Indian plate. Answer option C. The first statement, it is a major tectonic plate. Among the 6 major plate, Indian plate is on among that. And then it is the convergent plate boundary with Himalayas. And then the plate extends to Pakistan and Myanmar as well. The incorrect statement is, the Indian plate is tectonically separated from the peninsular Indian plate. It is wrong. The peninsular Indian plate and the Indian plate both are same. The peninsular plate is an integral part of the Indian plate. And the Indian plate extends to Rakhine Mountains of Myanmar in the east and Kirtar Mountains of Pakistan in the west. And then the subduction along Himalaya forms the northern plate boundary in the form of continent-continent convergence. Convergent movement was there in between Himalaya and the Indian plate. Next question. When two plates pass or slide past each other along the transform fault, it is called. Tussaud predicted three plate boundaries. They are constructive, destructive and conservative. Among that, when two plates slide past each other, it is known as constructive plate margin, destructive plate margin, conservative plate margin, none of the above. When two plates slide past each other, it is known as conservative plate boundary. Conservative plate margin means they are move slide past each other. And the two plates include the ocean plates and continental plates. Sometimes it is two continental plates, otherwise two ocean plates. Other plate boundaries are constructive or divergent plate margin. Next one, destructive or convergent plate margin. Constructive or divergent, as the name indicates, divergent means two plates move away from each other. Divergent plate margin, plates move away from each other. It is also known as constructive plate margin. Due to the divergent plate margins, the mid-Atlantic ridge is formed. And then the convergent, then convergent means two plates move towards each other. Convergence. And when two plates move towards each other, the subductions will happen. Otherwise, mountains formed. And these are formed due to the convergent plate margin. Convergent means two plates move towards each other. It's also known as destructive plate margin. And then the transform fault movement causes the formation of San Andreas fault. These are the three different types of plate boundaries. Divergent or constructive, convergent or destructive, then transform fault. The concept of seafloor spreading was proposed by seafloor spreading theory. Proposed by options Alfred Wegener, W.J. Morgan, Harry Hess, Tussaud Wilson. Answer is Harry Hess. Seafloor spreading theory related to Harry Hess. Theory was based on a thorough analysis of the magnetic properties of rocks that are present in either side of the mid-oceanic ridges. And he argued that the rupture of oceanic crust is due to the constant eruptions at the crust of oceanic ridges. And here new lava wedges into the crust and pushes it on either side. The ocean floor is pushed because of the volcanic eruption at the crust. It is the seafloor spreading theory by Harry Hess. Which of the following evidences support the hypothesis of seafloor spreading? The evidences are rocks on either side of mid-oceanic ridges have remarkable similarities. Earthquake fossils at mid-oceanic ridges are shallower than the oceanic trenches. Oceanic crust rocks are younger than the continental rock crust. The evidences that support seafloor spreading are answer all these are the evidences for seafloor spreading. Rocks on either side of mid-oceanic ridges, then earthquake fossils at mid-oceanic ridges are shallower than the oceanic trench, and then the oceanic crust rocks are younger than the continental rock crust. And the seafloor spreading means the oceanic crust is always renewing, and therefore it will be younger than the continental crust. Which of the following oceanic regions is the primary site of generation of new crust, hosting mineral resources and supporting new ecosystem? Which of the oceanic regions is the primary site of generation of a new crust? Littoral region, continental shelf, mid-oceanic ridge, continental rise. Primary site of generation of new crust. Then, according to the seafloor spreading, oceanic ridges is a site for generation of new crust.
Thanks for watching. If you feel it is useful, please like, share and subscribe.